I wish I could make reaction videos, but I was born in 1956. I've heard all these songs. What could I possibly react to?
Hey whippersnappers, Brian here at A Boomer Reacts. Welcome back. If this is your first time here, thanks for checking me out. I listen to rap and hip hop songs using lyric videos, and then I let you know what I thought about them. So as you can see, I'm going to be reacting to Retrospect for Life by Common featuring Lauryn Hill. So I've reacted to a lot of Common songs. And if you're curious about which ones, you can go check out my playlist because Common's got one. Let's see, Retrospect for Life is the first single from Common's third album, One Day It'll All Make Sense, released in 97. See if I've reacted to anything off of this. I don't think so. This was the last Common album to feature producer No ID until Common's 2011 album, The Dreamer, The Believer. It was also the first album in which Common officially dropped Sense from his name. Common says, quote, "My man, James Poyser, played the keys on it. There was actually a version without James, so we had him take a train to fix it up. Lauryn actually met James for the first time during this session, and he later went on to work on her The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. So that record has a lot of musical significance. There's a lot of stories about it," unquote. The song was produced by James Poyser and No ID. Cable management. Okay. Retrospect for Life.
Yo, we gotta start respecting life more, y'all. When you look at your brother, man, you gotta see yourself. You gotta see the God within him. We brothers getting changed real quick over nothing. We losing too many of ours. Gotta recreate, y'all. Yo, check it. Knowing you the best part of life, do I have the right to take yours? Cause I created you irresponsibly, subconsciously knowing the act. I was a part of the start of something. I'm not ready to bring it to the world. Had myself believing I was sterile. I look at your mother's stomach and wonder if you are a boy or a girl. Turning this woman's wound into a tomb, but she and I agree. A seed we don't need. You would have been much more than a mouth to feed. But someone, I would have fed this information I read to someone. My life for you, I would have had to lead. Instead, I led you to death. I'm sorry for taking your first breath, first step, and first cry. But I wasn't prepared mentally nor financially. Having a child shouldn't have to bring out the man in me. Plus, I wanted you to be raised within a family. I don't wanna go through the drama of having a baby's mama. Weekend visits and buying J's ain't gonna make me a father. For a while, bearing a child is something I never wanted to do. For me to live forever, I can only do that through you. Nerve, I got to talk about them niggas with a gun. Must have really thought I was God to take the life of my son. I could have sacrificed going out. To think my homies who did it, I used to joke about. From now on, I'ma use self-control instead of birth control. Cause $315 ain't worth your soul. $315 ain't worth your soul. $315 ain't worth it.
Tribulations, child's elimination, an integration of thoughts I feel about the situation. Back and forth, my feelings was patient. Happy deep down, but not joyed enough to have it. But even that's a lie, less than 2 weeks, we was back at it. Is this unprotected love, or safe to say it's lust busting? More than a sweat in somebody you trust. Or is it that we don't trust each other enough? And believe, having a child to make us have to stay together. But I want you in my life, cause you have made it better. Thinking we all in love, cause we can spend a day together.
together. We talking spending the rest of our lives. There's too many black women that can say they mothers but can't say that they wives. I wouldn't choose any other to mother my understanding, but I want our parenthood to come from planning. There's so much in my life that's undone. We gotta see eye to eye about family before we can't become one. If you had decided to have it, the situation I wouldn't run from, but I'm walking, finding myself and my God, so I can discipline my son with my rod. And I have a judge telling me how and when to raise my seed. Though his death was out our creed, with no one else to blame, I had a book of African names. Case our mind saying, just say your period hasn't came. And lately I've been sleepy, so quit smoking the weed and the beaties, and let's have this boy.
So is it up for interpretation whether she got an abortion or not? And because of Lauren's chorus, you know, I never dreamed you'd leave in summer, does that mean that, well, if this is autobiographical, does that mean that Common left regardless whether the baby was born or not? I don't know why he'd leave if the baby got aborted. Yeah. But he left. Lauren says so. So maybe it was just too awkward after her abortion. I thought the beat was very calming. That piano was awesome. And the beat was good too. And I love to hear Lauren, of course, on the chorus, she's great, but I love to hear her in the background of Common's verses too. It added a lot. He said something here that... Yeah, does Common have children? He's got a daughter. Omoye. And she was born the same year that this album came out, 97. I wonder if that was weird for him. You know, having this song become big while his daughter was being born. That would be interesting. So answer questions for me. Did she or did she not have an abortion? Did Common leave? And what else did I have? I think those are the two big questions. I mean, it's a very, very lovely song. The lyrics are very poignant. It's not going in my car because it's just too mellow. And the lyrics are too sad. But it was a good song. Well, thanks for hanging with me, guys. If you like this kind of content, give me a like and a subscribe. I'll see you on the next video. Bye.